Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. This is Grassroots NASCAR Racing and my name is Scott. So today, I gotta clear some of this stuff out. I have too many projects, too much stuff. It's time to have a little bit of a garage sale. So that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna walk you around a little bit, show you everything. We're gonna do a little garage sale. But before we dig into that, I gotta ask a big favor. When I dig into the back end of this channel, it shows that 91% of you people watching are not subscribed. So if you could do me a big favor, hit that subscribe button down in the corner. It'll help me a lot. It'll help grow the channel. And more importantly, it'll get this out there to more people so we can get new fans. And getting new fans is a huge deal because while I was looking at the back end of this channel, 90% of my viewers are 35 and older. 90%. That means only 10% are 35 and younger. The young crowd just isn't into NASCAR as much. We need to get them interested in this sport so it'll survive, so it'll grow. So do me a favor, hit that subscribe button. Let's grow this sport that we love. Anyway, that being said, let's dig into this. So what am I doing? Look behind me. There's just too much stuff. There's too much stuff everywhere. So I'm gonna sell some of this stuff. Be aware that I do live in Houston. So if you want any of this, some of the smaller things I'll be able to ship. A lot of the stuff I cannot ship. So that'll be on you figuring out how you want to do that. I might be coming up to North Carolina in March, somewhere around there. But yeah, so let's dig in. I'm going to start with the big stuff. Cars. Cars, cars, cars. I'm going to be selling probably three of my cars, something like that. I've got six cars in here right now. It's too much. I don't have time to work on six different cars. It's too much. So let's start with this one. This is the 1999 Rusty Wallace Ford Taurus. This one is in great shape. This is chassis PRS012. According to the Penske historian, this was a test car slash backup car that never made it onto the track. But this car is very complete. The only thing that this car is missing is the oil tank behind the driver's seat, which I have one that I'll throw in with the deal. And then in the engine, it's missing some of the engine internals. I get the feeling that this car was sold as kind of like a dealership showpiece to sit in a car dealership and look the part. But inside the engine, it is missing its rockers, lifters, cam, and pistons. As far as I know, that's what it's missing. I haven't torn it all apart to check and see, but yeah. So an engine shop can get that up and going again. But other than that, everything else is there. It's a great car, it's in great shape. Beautiful car. Then we'll go over here to this one. This is the 1991 Terry Labonte Sunoco Oldsmobile. So this is a true Terry Labonte car. I have the paperwork from when it was sold by Terry, signed by him. And I have all the paperwork from when it was sold from him to when I bought it. This thing is all original. I don't know about the engine in it. I just don't know what it is. It's got great power. It is a mean engine. But this thing has everything original in it. It's got tons of parts that are all marked, like TL1, TL3, just depending. I know there's markings on the spoiler, on some of the wheels. These are not the right wheels. The right wheels are right there. I'll show you on those. Let's see if you can see that right there. TL1. So those are the original wheels that I need to put back on. There's various parts under the hood that are marked. These pieces on the back side are marked. The air cleaner is marked. So this is a really cool car. You don't see a lot of these Oldsmobiles pop up anymore, especially in decent shape. So this is definitely a cool one. Now the next car is this one. So this is an old show car. We just found out the history on this one. Apparently this chassis was raced by Eddie Birchwile back in the late 80s. I got on the phone with Eddie and spoke to him, sent him pictures, and he says, oh yeah, that looks like my Daytona chassis. And it has a build date on it of January of 88. So I was asking him, like, is this the chassis that would have been raced in the 89 Daytona 500? He says, yep, that's the one. Well, in the 89 Daytona 500, Kyle Petty drove this chassis. So kind of cool, the history of it, that Kyle Petty drove this thing. But apparently it was later sold off and then converted to a show car. And that's how it sits now. It doesn't have a race engine. It's just a small block Chevy that's modified a little bit. It will need a little bit of tuning. It's one of these projects I haven't gotten to. If you watch the video, I'll link above here. When it starts up, it's got like a ting, 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 ting. So I don't know if a rocker is loose or something like that. Something on the top end. Nothing big, hopefully. And, but yeah. So that's one that could be up and running pretty easy. Could be a fun little track day car. These are the wheels that need to go back on it. I'll put those back on it and then put these back on that car. But it's a nice Lumina, you know. You don't see a lot of Luminas in great shape like this. Most of the time they're pretty beat. So this one's pretty cool. I did just replace the fuel cell in it not too long ago. The one that was in it was leaky. So I took the cell. I had put a new cell in this one. And the cell that was in this one, I put into this one. So that way you have a fuel cell that does not leak. The only thing that's really wrong, like I said, is the engine. You got to do a little tuning work on there. And then a few of the graphics need to be replaced. But that's pretty cheap, pretty easy. You can see some of the numbers are kind of peeling a little bit, but that's to be expected with age. Now, on this car, I'm kind of torn. I want really bad to get this thing up and running, but this is going to need a lot. It's basically just a chassis and a body. It doesn't have a fuel cell, doesn't have oil tank, drivetrain. It doesn't have a lot of stuff. So this one would need a little bit of work, but this is a true Kyle Petty car. I have paperwork on it. This is the chassis that Kyle got his last win in at Dover. I don't care what the Mecum people say, this is it, and I have the paperwork to show that. This is chassis number 13. You can see it there. It does have gauges. It is a Sabco panel. But yeah, it doesn't have too much. Now this car, again, I'm torn on it because I really, really want to get this thing up and running. It's such a beautiful car, but it's just going to take so much work that I don't really have time to do. But that one, if somebody offers me a good price, I'll sell it. These other ones, now, here's how I'm going to do this. I'm letting this stuff go. I'm not giving it away. But if you are interested, if you are serious and you have money, my email is in the description of this video. Shoot me an email and we can talk. We'll come up on a price that we can agree on. So those three cars are for sale. The Kyle Petty, if somebody offers me a good price, I'll let that one go. But let's dig into the sheet metal, the things around here. Obviously, there's a lot of stuff around here. This is the original number 88 that hung over the entrance to Hendrick Motorsports. And then after Junior left, they replaced it with the 5. So that's a cool piece. I'll be letting that go. But really anything around here. If you guys see anything around here, I'll put a link above right now to a video I did kind of walking around showing everything. But if there's a piece in here that you have always liked and you've thought, man, he'll never let go of that. I doubt he'll ever sell that. But if it's a piece that you've had your eye on that you think is really cool, now's the time. I don't let a lot of my stuff go, especially some of these nicer pieces. So if there's a piece that you are interested in, again, shoot me an email. It's in the video description and we'll hopefully come to a deal. But there's a lot of stuff in this shop. That's a cool Chase Elliott. That's from The Clash when he crashed. I've got the nose too from that. Yeah. Just gonna let some stuff go. I'll walk down here and show you these all these pieces of metal. This, good night. This thing is huge. This was a gift from my brother for Christmas. Crazy. This thing is so big. It's like 6 feet. But I think I'm gonna hang that up there above the TV. That should look pretty cool. Got a Jimmy Johnson nose up there. That was from the Daytona Road Course, I believe. But lots of good stuff. Here's a Danica side. This is a early Clint Boyer side right here. AC Delco, number two. I've got a Jimmy Johnson Ally side right here. And then a Danica Nature's Bakery, number 10. Jimmy Johnson rear. And a few other things. I might let this car too if somebody really wants it. This is a, you know, like a 98 Pontiac Grand Prix. It does have a fuel cell, does have its rear. Doesn't have an engine or a drivetrain. Needs some new glass in the back. But it's an interesting car. So yeah, time to let a few things go. That's an older piece. This was actually Morgan Shepherd. Morgan Shepherd in relief of Neil Bonnet. I believe this was Talladega, July 31st of 88. Qualified fifth at 193. That's a pretty cool piece. I love it when they have character like that. So anyway, guys, if you see anything you like, let me know. I'm gonna take you over to the house here real quick. Show you a couple pieces inside the house. And then, yeah, so let's go take a look at the house. A couple more pieces in the shop here. That one's autographed. I got a Dale Jr. rear. And this is the nose I was talking about. Chase Elliott nose from the Daytona Clash. Got wrecked pretty hard. Okay, so we're in the house. This is my little game room. You can see a lot of pieces on the walls around here. But again, if you see anything that you like, let me know. This is a Dale Jr. 2016 Richmond, I believe. That, man, I don't know if I'm gonna sell that. That is an awesome piece. Very rare to find a Jeff Gordon side that long, that intact, with the colors still so vibrant. They're almost always faded and smaller. This is from 1994 in Phoenix. Again, if somebody offers me a really good amount on that, I'll let it go, but otherwise I prefer not to sell that. This is a Dale Jr. throwback Darlington tire. That's a Jimmy Johnson throwback. This is when Jimmy Johnson ran the seven-time scheme with Dale Earnhardt and Richard Petty. This used to hang inside a Hooters. I don't know how many of these they made. I know of two others that exist, but kind of a cool piece. Crew suit, I'll sell that. That is a truck hood from William Byron. This I will sell. All right, this is a Dale Jr. number 8 wheel. You can see, let's see. So you can see right there, DEI 8. And it's got its number 8 sticker in there. Number 8 up there. That's kind of cool, obviously in a wreck. But I'd let that go. That's kind of cool piece. Jimmy Johnson waterfall. I might even let that go. Kyle Petty side, this is later. This is 93 or 94. Might be 94 with that No Fear. This was the jack point right here with that sticker. Got a couple crew suits here that I'd let go. That's autographed by Junior. Now let's see, let's go take a look at a couple other pieces. All right, that's the rear to that side that I have in the game room. That's from the All-Star Race, the Baja Blast car. And then over here, I've got a Richard Petty nose autographed. That one's pretty cool. Definitely shows some race use. A little sandblasted. And I've got this one. Nice Terry Labonte side. I haven't done the research on this one to figure out where it was run, but it shouldn't be too hard with these donuts on it. But I love the jack point on that one. That's cool. The sticker up here, well, that sticker says 92. I don't think that's right. Probably just using an old sticker. I don't know. But that's a cool one. Got the MRO sticker on there. I've also got these as well. These are Kyle Petty autographed gloves and shoes. These are from his Hot Wheel days. Got a little plaque in there. Some photos from the day that these were given to this young man. But pretty cool. Okay, so like I said, if you see anything that you are interested in, let me know. We can maybe work out a deal. My email is in the description of the video. Cars, sheet metal, let me know. But remember, I'm not giving this stuff away. I'm just trying to move some stuff. I'm not gonna be crazy about it, but we can certainly come to a deal on some stuff, but especially on the cars, if you have money, if you're ready to pull the trigger on a car, let me know. If you're just tire kicking, you don't have money, you know, nobody likes to waste their time, but yeah, they're great cars. They deserve to be on the track. It's so hard for me to do it living here in Texas to get them on track enough, you know. So I'd really like to see them go to a good home where somebody could put them on the track more than I can. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys are having a good winter. Gosh, I know I'm dying to get some racing on TV again. It drives me crazy. I do try and save some races. I DVR them and try and save some so I can just put them on in the background so I can hear the cars, you know. It's comforting to be cleaning the house and you can hear a race going in the background. So, but anyway, guys, take care and I will see you in the next one.